It's the John Online Podcast on Dana and Jeffrey in the morning. All right, I'm on the line with Robbie Coltrane. You know him best as Hagrid from the Harry Potter films. Dude, it is such a dream come true for me to be talking to you this morning. I've grown up with Harry Potter. I'm a diehard fan. I promise you I'm not going to bombard you with Hagrid questions, though. I promise.
Good man.
You're probably sick of hearing
it. You grew up with Harry Potter. What age are you?
I'm currently 24.
Get out of town.
I am.
You were just hitting your adolescence with the first... God, how extraordinary, because there's whole generations, of course, like that.
I was in, I believe I was in seventh grade when the first film came out.
Wowee.
So I definitely, you helped shape my childhood, sir, so thank you. This is a real, I'm serious,
well,
it's a dream come true.
Well, I'm sorry to hear you're a complete delinquent.
And I can't tell you how many times
I'm speaking from rehab, ladies and gentlemen.
And maybe you could judge me, I've been doing this for years, but I mean, you could tell me how shitty I am at it, but you're a wizard, Harry, and a thumping good one, I'd wager. How was that?
But not bad at all.
All right, so, Robbie, now you're promoting your film Great Expectations, which is currently playing in select theaters. Now, can you tell us about the film?
Well, the film's a very good adaptation by David Nichols of the book, Great Expectations. And Great Expectations means that it's an expression people used to use, meaning that one day you were likely to inherit half of Northumberland. And because that's how people got rich in those days. You either owned land or somebody who did own land took an interest in you. It's pre-industrial revolution, pre the middle class. So your chances of changing your circumstances were absolutely minimal unless somebody who was very rich took an interest in you, which is what happens to Pitt. And one minute he's making horseshoes and the next minute he's suddenly catapulted to a sort of rather decadent upper class life in London, and he's wearing silk suits and bow brummeling around town.
Can you tell us about the character that you're playing?
Sure. He's a guy called Jaggers, who's a lawyer. He's a manipulative swine who manipulates everybody's lives and pretty well manipulates the plot of the story. And he's got his fingers in lots of pies, and he's manipulating Pip's life and Magwitch's life and Miss Havisham, of course. So he's kind of running everything in a kind of invisible way. He has endless little conversations with various characters, and he tells one person one thing and another person another.
It must be refreshing for you to, like, step out of the Hagrid pants, literally, just, you know, and play a little bit of a different character now.
Playing Hagrid for 10 years, you know, it'd be jolly nice to play a swine for a change.
I was actually just going to ask. I mean, yeah, we've seen you in Ocean's 12, European Vacation, Brave. But so you've had all this ridiculous success. Now, can you tell us, how did it all come together for you before all this, before Hagrid?
Well, I left art school. I did drawing and painting at art school. I used to sort of design posters for plays, and I'd always fancied myself as a bit of an actor. But I didn't really think it was going to happen to me. You know, that happens to a lot of people, and they regret it when they're older. I thought I'd give it a shot, and I started off doing sketch shows, you know, doing comedy and Saturday Live in Britain and so forth, and then I started getting offered what I call proper parts, you know.
Right.
I did a TV series called Tutti Frutti, where I played an aging rock and roll band who suddenly have a hit because one of their old records gets used in a Gene commercial, which was unbelievable.
Are you in the band?
Yeah, I play keyboards and stuff.
Ooh, do you play music in real life?
I play keyboards.
Oh, you do? So it's perfect.
This is, well, they didn't ask me to be a drummer, really.
I just got to ask you, if it's okay if I could ask you a Hagrid question.
Go on.
All right. So, I mean, so you auditioned for the role of Hagrid. Now, I'm assuming there wasn't too much competition.
It was Jo Rowland's decision. She said I was the only person who could play Hagrid. So that made negotiations very easy.
I mean, how tall are you in real life compared to the character?
I'm 6'1".
You're 6'1". And how tall is Hagrid?
8'6".
8'6". So I'm assuming there was a lot of special effects going on there. Or were you wearing stilts?
The special effects, you've got to remember, we're talking about a 10-year period. I mean, the special effects have come on in CGI, you know, thanks to Pixar and people like that. And also thanks to Harry Potter, there was an awful lot of programs invented for CGI by the crew on Potter. There was about 400 of them at one time.
Because of Harry Potter?
Sitting in front of their Macs doing it all. And initially when we started, we had to use the old techniques they developed for the movies.
Right.
You know, where, you know, you'd be walking along a big tall box or the other person would be walking along a trench, or, I mean, as primitive as that.
So more so camera tricks.
Yeah, and an awful lot of maths involved. People were forever looking at slide rules and calculators and working out if this is going to work. And it was pretty boring, actually, I mean, technically, for those of us who are involved. And then suddenly somebody said, no, what we'll do is on the wide shots where Hagrid's walking with, say, 100 kids, you really can't fake that. So they came up with all these CGI programs.
That is awesome. Man, it's been sensational talking to you this morning. Please put in a good word at Hogwarts for me, please. And tell the Sorting Hat I really want Gryffindor.
You know something that's quite interesting statistically? When kids are young, they all want to go to Gryffindor. And as they get more moody in adolescence, they think maybe they'd rather be in Slytherin.
Really?
Yeah.
No way.
Funny.
I've always wanted to be in Gryffindor, mainly because Emma Watson, but we'll move on from that. Robbie Coltrane promoting Great Expectations in select theaters now, so go see it. Thanks, Robbie.
God bless.
Later.
Dana and Jeffrey in the morning. Catch more weekday mornings and online anytime at the Dana and Jeffrey Facebook page.